Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we shall discuss how to choose the measure of center and variability for the given data. We have studied three measures of center, that is mean, median and mode. But the question arises, for the given data, which method should we use to find its center, that is mean, median or mode? The choice of measure of center depends on three main things. First, extreme values or the outliers. Second, data set having many identical numbers. And third, gaps in the middle of data. Let us consider the three data sets. Now, in the first data set, we see that there are 7 items having value 5. Let us make a dot plot for this data. In this data, 1 is given once, so we mark 1 once. 2 is given 2 times, so we mark 2 twice. 3 is given once, so we mark 3 once. 4 is given twice, so we mark 4 twice. 5 is given 7 times, so we mark 5 7 times. 6 is given twice, so we mark 6 2 times. Now clearly we can see that 5 is mode, as it has the highest frequency. So in this case, mode is the appropriate choice of center. Now we take the second set of data, which is given as 2, 3, 5, 6, 4, 7, 1, 8, 6. Now we see that there are no outliers here. So we can find mean. We can also choose median, but mean is a more appropriate choice. Than median, because it will take into consideration all the data values rather than only the middle value. So we find mean, and we know that mean is given by sum of all the values divided by the total number of terms in the data set. So we have 2, plus 3 plus 5 plus 6 plus 4 plus 7 plus 1 plus 8 plus 6 divided by 9, and the sum is equal to 42, and we divide it by 9, and therefore we get 4.66 as the mean. And to find median, we arrange this data set in the ascending order. Now we know that median is given by the middlemost term in the series, and there are odd number of terms given. So the fifth term is the middlemost term. Therefore, the median is given by 5, which is the fifth term in this series. Whenever we can use both mean and median, we see that there is not much difference between the values of mean and median. Now we take another data set, that is 2, 5, 60, 3, 6, 4, 3 and 2, and here we notice that there are no big gaps and there exists an outlier 60, that is the value which is very large from rest of the values. That is, we have an outlier and its value is given as 60. Since there is an outlier, so we suppose to choose mean as the measure of center, and mean is given by sum of all the values divided by the total number of terms in the series, and here we have the sum as 2 plus 5 plus 60 plus 3 plus 6 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 divided by 8, which is equal to 85 by 8, that is 10.6. so we get the value of mean as 10.6. and if we choose median as the measure of center, to find median, we first arrange this series in ascending order. Now we know that median is the middle value, and since there are even number of terms in this series, that is we have 8 terms, so median will be given by the mean of middle two terms, that is the fourth term and the fifth term. So median is given by mean of fourth and fifth term. The fourth term is given by 3 and the fifth term is given by 4, and mean of these two terms is given by 3 plus 4 by 2, which is equal to 7 upon 2, that is 3.5. So for this series, we get the value of mean as 10.6 and the value of median is 3.5. Now we see that all values except 60 are near to median, but no value is near to mean. So we say mean is affected by extreme value. Because it is sum of all the values divided by the number of terms in data, and here among all values we add a very large value to all other values, which will have effect on the calculation. So it is appropriate to use median when an outlier is given, and the gap between the values is not much, and median is a positional average, so it is not affected by outliers, now we can summarize the above explanation as: when there are no outliers given, then mean is useful and median is useful when there are outliers or extreme values and no big gap between values of data, and mode is useful when the data has many identical numbers. Now we are going to discuss choice of measure of variation, that is how to choose the measure of variation for the given data. We have studied three measures of variation, that is range, interquartile range, and mean absolute deviation. Now range only takes into consideration the minimum and the maximum values, does not consider all the values, so range is not always reliable. Whenever we have an outlier, we always use center as median. Thus here the variation should be measured using interquartile range, especially when we use box and whisker plot to represent the data. When we choose mean as center, so it is appropriate to use mean absolute deviation, to measure variation. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.